After a very long time, we've heard a cabinet minister speak so humbly and so openly. Really, thank you so much. And I think I would be speaking for everyone else here that everybody was waiting to hear from you. And today they'll go back feeling very, very hopeful. So thank you very much. Can we request you to join us on stage again? And Mr. Puri, can we please have you on stage? And Mr. Amit Kumar, we are about to begin the award ceremony. Well, it is that time of the evening that we've worked for and we've been waiting for a long time. Let's begin with our first category, Sustained Wealth Creation Medium Enterprises. And the nominees are Pius Thomas of Page Industries, V. Sundaresan of TTK Prestige, and Amit Jain of Zydus Wellness. And the winner is, well, Mr. Pius Thomas of Page Industries. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for Mr. Thomas. Let's quickly hear it out from the jury members on what they have to say on Mr. Thomas.
This was really going by the numbers, and this this company really stood out by a fair distance from its peer group, both within the industry, which is how it came into the final consideration, but also as we compared its parameters across the shortlisted group, it was far above its competitors.
Well, Mr. Thomas, can we please have you up here on stage? Many congratulations and a big round of applause for Mr. Pius Thomas of Page Industries, Sustained Wealth Creation Medium Enterprises Best CFO. Let's hear it for the first award of the evening, please. Moving on to our next category, Sustained Wealth Creation Large Company, and the nominees are Saman Chakrabarty of Dr. Reddy's Laboratories, Kevin P. Deesa of Bajaj Auto, and Rajesh Gupta of Havells India. And the winner is Mr. Kevin P. Deesa of Bajaj Auto. Unfortunately, he couldn't be here with us today, so he's of course sent his good wishes to everybody, and we wish him the very best. Let's move on now to our next category. Remarkable Leverage Management Mid-Size Companies. And the nominees are Rajkumar Baheti of Alembic Pharmaceuticals, Ajit Kumar Jain of Ipca Laboratories, and R.K. Agarwal of Jagran Prakashan. And the winner is, well, it is Mr. Rajkumar Baheti of Alembic Pharmaceuticals. Many, many congratulations, Mr. Baheti. Let's hear it out from the jury.
Well, despite drug pricing controls in the domestic market and intensive competition, both in the domestic and international market, I think it's one of the excellent examples of managing leverage in such high competitive market, and they are having leadership position, especially in the chronic segment.
Well, a big round of applause. Can we have you up here, Mr. Baheti, on stage, please? Let's hear it for Mr. Rajkumar Baheti of Alembic Pharmaceuticals, Best CFO Award in Remarkable Leverage Management in a Medium-Sized Company. Congratulations once again. Let's move on to our next category, Remarkable Leverage Management Large Company, and the nominees are Saman Chakrabarty of Dr. Reddy's Laboratories, Ashok Bhandari of Shree Cement, and Mr. Rajesh Gupta of Havells India. And the winner is, well, it is Mr. Ashok Bhandari of Shree Cement. Let's see what the jury had to say for Mr. Bhandari.
Despite being in a capital intensive industry, it has been able to keep its leverage low and operating efficiency very high. It is a very fit case for other CFOs to follow, emulate how they can operate under a very low leverage and have high operational efficiencies.
Well, a big round of applause for Mr. Bhandari. Mr. Bhandari, Can we please have you up on stage, please? Well, the evening has just started. Can we hear it for the winners, please? Let's move on to our next category, Consistent Liquidity Management, Medium-Sized Company. And the nominees are Rohitash Gupta of eClerks Services, Hemant Kumar Ruya of Agrotech Foods, and Rosto Ravanan of Mindtree. And the winner is, well, it is Rosto Ravanan of Mindtree. He's unfortunately not well and he had to cancel his trip last minute, but many congratulations to Mr. Ravanan. Let's move on to our next category, Consistent Liquidity Management, Large Companies. And the nominees are Mr. Ganesh Murthy of Emphasis, Mr. A.K. Mukherjee of Exide Industries, Mr. Anil Yadav of IRB Infrastructure Developers. And the winner is, well, it is Mr. Ganesh Murthy of Emphasis, who's of course since moved to Dell. Many congratulations, Mr. Murthy. Can we also hear it out from the jury on Mr. Murthy?
What we found from the figures that we saw was that there was an intense pressure put by the CFO to do all that he could to improve the bottom line. We were particularly impressed by the fact that he cut the working cycle quite significantly. And there were many other features as to his practices and behavior, which we felt justified giving him the award.
Can we please have Mr. Murthy up on stage? Many congratulations, Mr. Murthy. A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for Mr. Ganesh Murthy. Let's move on to our next category, Best Transformation Agent, Medium-Sized Company. And the nominees are Rosto Ravanan of Mindtree, V. Sundaresan of TTK Prestige, and Mr. Rajesh Kumar Mohata of Speciality Restaurants. And the winner is, well, it is none other than Mr. Rajesh Kumar Mohata of Speciality Restaurants. A big round of applause for Mr. Mohata. Can we have you up here, please? Mr. Mohata. Behind mainland China or Calcutta and a series of specialized restaurants. Many congratulations, Mr. Mohata. Moving on to our next category, Best Transformation Agent, Large Company. And the nominees are Sandeep Batra of Pidilite Industries, Adish Gupta of Grasim Industries, and Kevin Pidisa of Bajaj Auto. And the winner is, well, it is Sandeep Batra of Pidilite Industries. A big round of applause for Mr. Batra. Mr. Batra, please, can we have you up here on stage? What's with the applause? Can we honor the winners? Congratulations. Moving on to our next category, Enhancing Competitiveness Through M&As. Let's take a look at the nominees. Well, it's Rajiv Bansal of Infosys, Adish Gupta of Grasim Industries, and Mr. Alok Agarwal of Reliance Industries. And the winner is, well, Adish Gupta of Grasim Industries. Unfortunately, he had to cancel his visit last minute, but many congratulations to Mr. Gupta. Moving on to our next category, Best CFO of a PSU. Let's take a look at the nominees. Well, it's L. Kulshreshtha of Gujarat Mineral Development Corporation, Nitish Bhandari of Gujarat Gas Company, and Rajesh Agarwal of Indraprastha Gas. And the winner is, well, it is Mr. L. Kulshreshtha of Gujarat Mineral Development Corporation. A big round of applause. And let's also hear it out from the jury on Mr. Kulshreshtha.
They have a very good track record of maintaining their ROE of 26% and PAT of about 29%. And their ROCE, their return on capital employment, is the highest. Their turnover, again, has been showing very impressive improvement, etc. Considering all this, jury was very pleased to give this award to Mr. Kulshreshtha of Gujarat Mineral Development Corporation.
Well, not an easy jury to please, and Mr. Kulshreshtha did a fabulous job. Many congratulations. Let's move on now to our next category, Best CFO of a PSU Large Enterprise. And the nominees are Mr. R.K. Garg of Petronet LNG, Mr. A.K. Banerjee of Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, and Mr. Swaminathan Thyagarajan of NMDC. And the winner is, well, Mr. R.K. Garg of Petronet. Well, let's take a look at what the jury had to say on Mr. R.K. Garg.
For the work which is being done in Petronet, especially when the disparity of gas prices and the LNG is there, and the work which is being done under geopolitical constraints, Kochi terminal construction, despite that, they have shown the highest turnover and highest profit. I think the CFO of Petronet truly deserved this award.
Well, a big round of applause for Mr. Garg. Many congratulations. Let's move on to our next category, Best CFO of an MNC medium-sized company. And the nominees are Mr. Tapan Book of PNG Hygiene and Healthcare, Mr. Thomas Hoffman of Bayer Crop Science, and Mr. Rajiv Sonalkar of Abbott India. And the winner is Mr. Tapan Book of Procter & Gamble Hygiene and Healthcare. Big round of applause for him. Unfortunately, he could not be here with us today, but he sent his best wishes to every winner. Let's move on to our next category. Best CFO of an MNC large company, and the nominees are Ramakrishna Subramaniam of GlaxoSmithKline Consumer Healthcare, Mr. Rajiv Batra of Cummins India, and Mr. Soumitra Bhattacharya of Bosch. And the winner is, well, it is Mr. Ramakrishna Subramaniam of GlaxoSmithKline Consumer Healthcare. A big round of applause. And also, let's quickly listen in on what the jury had to say on Mr. Subramaniam.
The one that we picked, the financial parameters actually improved quite significantly in a pretty difficult environment. And within those financial parameters, the one that stood out for me was the one on working capital. And in the case of Glaxo, the winner of this category, the working capital cycle was actually negative 4 days, which is very impressive in the environment that we are in.
Well, a big round of applause for Mr. Ramakrishnan. Many congratulations, sir. Let's move on to our next category, and this is my favorite category, Best Woman CFO, simply because there are so few women, especially in as chief financial officers. Let's take a look at the nominees. Pratibha K. Advani of NIIT Technologies, Nalini Rajan of Tara Jewels, and Anita S. Ravankar of Saskin Communication Technology. And the winner is, well, it is Pratibha K. Advani of NIIT Technology. A big round of applause for Ms. Advani. Let's also take a look at what the jury had to say on Ms. Advani.
Today the women are breaking the glass ceiling, and it was really a pleasure for jury to select Ms. Advani from NIIT Technology, because area of education is very important, and the kind of work which is being done in NIIT, the kind of growth which is being shown in on all the financial parameters, she deserved that award.
Many congratulations, Ms. Advani. This is a category which we've recently instituted. I think this is our second year. And it's always an exciting process for us to pick the best woman CFO. Many congratulations and a loud round of applause, please. Let's move on now to our next category, commitment towards triple bottom line. And the nominees are Mr. Tapan Book of P&G Hygiene and Healthcare, Mr. Subbu Subramaniam of Titan Industries, and Mr. Shubhinder Duggal of Nestle India. And the winner is, well, it is Mr. Subbu Subramaniam of Titan Industries. Let's also take a listen on what the jury had to say on Mr. Subramaniam.
Titan had demonstrated great commitment in terms of giving hundreds of scholarships to young children in Tamil Nadu, in actually adopting villages, in empowering rural women. And of course, the more you invest in your people, the more your bottom line grows. And therefore, we felt Titan was a good candidate for this one.
Many congratulations, Mr. Subramaniam. A big round of applause for Mr. Subbu Subramaniam of Titan Industries. Well, it is time for the final and the award of the year. Who is the best CFO in India today? Well, in this category, there are absolutely no nominees. There is only one winner. And that is, any guesses? Well, he's not the CFO. Well, that is Mr. Soumen Chakrabarty. Big round of applause for Mr. Soumen Chakrabarty of Dr. Reddy's Laboratories. And let's hear it out from what the jury had to say on Mr. Chakrabarty.
We looked for a company which had been scoring high, if not winning, across a range of categories. The company that we finally chose could have won in at least two categories. But given that it figured so prominently across categories, we felt that it deserved the all-round award, and that's the base on which we chose to award it to this company.
Well, a big round of applause for Mr. Soumen Chakrabarty. Louder, please. He is the best CFO. And we can assure you, he had some stiff competition. Let's also now unveil his picture on the cover of the magazine. Let's unveil the cover, please. To point towards the screen. Well, a big round of applause for India's best CFO. Goel has a question here. If Mr. Chakrabarty is single.
I was worried there would be too many suitors for him.
But there aren't very many women in the audience. So. Well, can we please invite all the winners on stage, and can we request you to please stay on stage? And please come up with your trophies for you to remember this evening by. We'll do a nice group photograph. Can we hear it once more for the best chief financial officers who really have a very, very difficult job? Because whenever we don't get increments, we blame the CFOs. So let's hear it for the best CFOs who've done a fabulous job of keeping their employees very happy. Well, thank you very much, all the CFOs who came down to Delhi, and Mr. Piyush Goyal, Mr. Puri, Mr. Kumar, thank you very much. It's been a fabulous evening, and it would not have been possible without the support of Yes Bank, who was our presenting sponsor, Ipsos, our survey partner, ET Now, our television partner, and Glenlivet, our beverage partner. Thank you very much. Please, let's continue the celebrations outside over cocktails and dinner. Thank you very much, and we'll see you again next year. Thanks.